G'day everyone, I hope we're all doing well. Welcome back to another video, and today my sister and I are finally continuing our reaction series to her first time watching the Saw movies. Today we're going to be watching Saw 6, and the reason why I'm recording this bit separate from her is that when we recorded our intro yesterday, I forgot to turn on the mic, so therefore that entire portion of the video was just fucked. And we didn't realize till afterwards, and we didn't really feel like re-recording the intro or anything, so we just watched the movie and we turned on the mic afterwards and recorded it separate. So I'm just giving you my intro now, and I've got to say she was really excited for this one, especially because she knew that this was one of my favorite Saw movies. It is up there in my top three favorite Saw films, and I can't wait for you guys to see her reaction. But as a quick update, I will be continuing the How to Beat Every Saw Trap series that I was doing. I've already covered Spiral, Saw 1, Saw 2, and Saw 3. I know a lot of you are waiting for Saw 4 and 5, but at the same time, those videos take a very long time to make. It takes me watching the trap sequences over and over again, basically frame by shot by shot and everything, trying to find all these little details, writing the scripts for those videos, and then recording it and editing it, and it takes an obnoxious amount of time to actually make those videos. I want to finish my sister and I's reactions to the Saw movies before I continue that series. Don't worry. It is coming. I know a lot of you are really requesting it and looking forward to that series continuing, and that's why I'm incorporating this little update right now, so that you guys know what's happening. It's been hard for us to record our reaction videos as well to the Saw movies because she's focusing on school at the moment, because she has school full-time. I work full-time during the day as well, but we've been able to record the Saw 6 and Saw 3D reactions now, mainly for the reason that in Brisbane here in Australia, we're back in lockdown and she can't really go to school. She's doing homeschool, but she has a little bit more free time. I can't work because my line of work kind of relies on there not being a lockdown. But at the same time, these series are continuing. I'll also have separate reviews for the Cube movies, because when I recorded my Cube reaction the other day, I forgot to press record, and I don't want to fake a reaction for you guys, so I'm going to do separate reviews for that instead. For my Cube 2 Hypercube review, I am going to have a special guest, but when it comes to Cube Zero, which is the third Cube movie, I will be doing a reaction, mainly for the reason of I have never seen that movie. And then the Hostel Part 2 and Part 3 reactions will be happening, as well as reactions to Part 2 and Part 3 of Fear Street will be coming very, very soon as well. I have recorded both of those already. But guys, either way, I'm really excited to show you guys this reaction. I hope you will enjoy. My sister was really excited to watch it. But without further ado, let's get into the reaction. I'm really excited for you to see this trap, by the way. This opening trap in Saw 6 is quite possibly one of, if not the goriest trap in the entire series.
Don't lean forward!
What's going on? Says don't lean forward! What does he do?
Leans forward.
Who will offer the most flesh in order to save their life? The choice is yours.
Oh, it does it gradually!
Yeah, but it still seems slightly more merciful.
No! Yeah, she's got nothing. Oh!
Knee cleaver time! Pop!
It's gotten to the point she can't feel anything.
I guess you can say she went ham.
Pop goes the weasel. Oh no, they...
Hey! My Pescetti!
Why is he looking up there?
You'll find out later.
What's his
head? Umbrella! It's Resident Evil! No T-Virus!
Not that, but as lead counsel for this company, if you screw up, it comes down on my ass, so...
Better than that.
It says here you had oral surgery to remove a cyst from your jaw.
Oral.
It has nothing to do with some oral surgery I had 30 years ago.
He said oral again.
You are a goddamn criminal.
I mean, you should expect that with a company named Umbrella.
Yeah. I'm on my way.
If someone says, I'm on my way in that tone, you know they're evil. Just fucking arrest them right there.
We also got a right index off the scale.
Been ID'd yet?
Yeah. They're Agent Strong's.
He took his fingers.
He took his something.
We have fingerprints. Something we didn't know about. Or his hand.
She's alive!
Perez.
He wanted us to learn.
And did you?
Look at me. Look at my goddamn arm!
What the fuck am I supposed to learn from this, huh? Look at my arm! Fuck, I forgot a drink. I'm thirsty. No, I want Pepsi! Pepsi!
I need Pepsi!
Drink healthy!
Pepsi!
Pepsi! Pepsi!
Healthy!
Pepsi!
Healthy!
Pepsi!
Get out of my chair.
I'm not in your chair!
That same knife was used in only one other victim.
That victim was Seth Baxter, the man who killed your sister. The tape from the latest victim was missing, so we're looking into the Seth Baxter tape.
Maybe a different person made the tape, too.
Strong.
Yeah, maybe.
She's suspicious of him.
Sorry?
She's suspicious of him.
Both of them are.
Here.
From now on, I work alone.
I know.
Methadone is a masking agent. It doesn't heal, it simply numbs the senses.
Fucking hell, what the hell did she smoke to hallucinate this crap? Can I have some?
Unmasking agents, do you call that recovery?
It's not that simple.
Addiction is not that simple.
Wake up!
These people have...
What are you thinking so far?
I like it. Still time for me to change my mind.
I don't think you will. It just gets better, in my opinion, this movie.
I'll be the judge of that.
Just this past week, a new so-called game was discovered with grisly results.
This is still within the week of Jigsaw's death, by the way. Literally, Saw 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7, I think, take place within the events of 1 week. Because they just mentioned on the telly just then, this past week, Jigsaw's body was found in what seems of a grisly murder or something along those lines.
Don't fucking move.
And that's the end of Jigsaw. Ah, just kidding.
Oh, shit.
Trust someone who works at a company named Umbrella to shoot his own fucking employees.
Hello, William.
Oh, jeez.
When faced with death, who should live?
Is John Kramer your bestie?
John Kramer, I follow his teachings.
Religiously.
The straps on your arms and legs will detonate.
What?
Oh yeah, like explosive devices.
Look closely.
Glorious!
Mom! Wake up!
Did you ever see the Diary of a Wimpy Kid movies, by the way?
Yes, he is the older brother.
Roderick.
Yes.
Before he was in Diary of a Wimpy Kid, he was in Saw.
As you do, you go from horror to...
Whatever the fuck that was.
Yeah.
Hold your breath!
This is a very tense sequence. I love it. Imagine being in this situation. This would be awful. Whoa.
He's peed himself.
Hourglass body?
I guess you can say William really crushed the competition. She's not impressed. Housekeeping!
What makes you think you can just come to my door like this? Because I found something you want to see.
Where'd you get this?
It was at the location where John died. Does it mean anything to you?
No.
I think every single fucking time she walks down that hallway, the moment she turns down the hallway is when she's going to get kidnapped. Every fucking time I watch this movie, no matter how many times I've seen it. Now she gets kidnapped. There we go.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
See, he seems like such a lovely man. He seems so nice.
And he died in such a brutal way. Not only was he battling cancer, but he got his throat slit.
Yeah, not like he was doing anything else on the side, like a hobby, killing people, torturing them, making them kill themselves. You know, just a perfectly fine man.
Yeah, he's not a saint at all. He's just lovely.
But you're not taking into consideration the most important human element of all.
Which is what?
Family. The will to live.
Did you say family? Got fucking Dominic Toretto over here.
What was the other guy?
A perfectly healthy man with no living relatives. Just letting you know, each trap is, signified and plays out the same way as what his policies at Umbrella Health does. So therefore, his test is basically pointing out the flaws in his policy and his system with his, company.
Can't he just let go of both?
Imagine if he did. I'm very curious to see what happened if he did let go of both. I love how the entire time... Oh, he's fucked.
He made the wrong choice.
We all swing differently, don't we? Wait. But like, I love this scene because the entire time as well, to build up tension, it focuses on the fact of if he's going to let go of the woman. It shows her constantly and primarily focuses on her cutting back and forth between him and her as if he's going to choose her to die, but in the end, he makes the opposite choice to let the male die. Mm. I think it's absolutely brilliant. Oh.
What?
We're back at Saw 3.
Welcome to the rack.
Why'd you come?
Stop. Don't do this.
I promise you. When all this is done, I will provide a way out for you.
Oh, so sweet.
He still loves her.
Of course he does.
She still loves him.
Of course she does.
At your age, and with the development of your cancer, it's simply not feasible for Umbrella.
Wait. What's not feasible?
It's policy, John. It's policy.
I've got to say, John, this is kind of on you. You know, are with a company called Umbrella. That, if you go with a company named Umbrella, that's kind of a given that you're going to fucking die.
Miranda.
John.
The best line in the entire movie. Just one simple word.
Miranda.
So we're at around about the 56-minute mark. What do you think?
I like it.
Good. Really happy about that. Really happy to know you're enjoying this.
Let the game begin.
You look incredibly constipated. You wanted to know what those stitches were?
Can you get her out?
Yep.
Is it you?
What? I can get it!
That's one mind fuck, isn't it? She's gonna wake up with a real headache.
Production of R12 ceased in 1994, so the question is, was the contaminant we found at the site already, or did Strom bring it in with him?
Yeah, we're looking into the building's function before it was abandoned.
Uh-huh. Oh, they're on his tail.
He's gotta find a way to get rid of them.
We got it. This is our smoking gun.
The lab's off site. Come on.
He's gonna put them through a car crash.
You think he's gonna put them through a car crash?
Like, he's gonna make it so it crashes.
Wouldn't that be suspicious if he survived?
He'll make it so he gets injured, but they die.
Hey! Who's in there?
Mr. Houston? Is that you?
Yeah, Shelby?
We're all in here, sir. All six of us. What the hell is going on?
What can you see?
The carousel.
It's called the carousel.
I know of the name, but I've never seen it.
This is one of the best traps in the entire film. In the entire series.
Six ride the carousel. But only two can get off.
Six ride the carousel, only two can get off. Only one third of people who apply for claims and everything at his company get accepted, so one third can get off.
Yay!
He rejects two thirds of life and only accepts one third, so he has to do the same thing here. They're all pleading for their lives and telling him either truths or lies to try and survive. Owie!
She is already trying to lie! And she's just gonna continue to do it!
He's chosen his two to save.
Yep, but what I love is the fact that he presses it, not even giving a shit about who's next. He already had his hand on the button. He doesn't want to make the choice anymore. So he just presses it for whoever's next, showing growth in his character and also how this is actually hurting him.
Yeah.
And showing how wrong he's been all this time.
Your policy!
It's bullshit!
Fucking bullshit! Who are
you listening? Oh, the line delivery is awful, but I love it. Look at me! When you're killing me, you look at me!
You can turn his algorithm upside down and let us hear what he really sounds like.
He's looking a bit nervous. They already know.
And he already knows that they already know.
Mm-hmm.
On further analysis of Strom's fingerprints, it was found that the uric acid levels and the eccrine residue were inconsistent. Strom was already dead.
Right now, you're
there
feeling
it is.
Helpless. Right now, you're feeling.
Uh oh. Oh! Yikes! Match made in heaven. I gotta say, it's getting hot in there, isn't it? I gotta say. This movie right now is pretty lit. I got so many more. I'm here all night.
Get used to me.
Yeah, that's a note he wrote to Amanda.
Did we ever find out? Oh, wait, never.
It's the note that he wrote to Amanda in Saw 3.
Yeah, did we ever find out what it said?
That he knew, that Hoffman knew she was there the night that Jill and John lost their child. Fucking men always thinking with their penises.
If you fail, you will never see your family again.
What are you doing here?
Will!
Hello?
Hello, Tara. My apologies for exposing you and your son to this kind of treatment, but I can assure you it is not without reason.
I love this version of the Hello Zep theme, by the way. It's so good.
It's not my game.
Have mercy, please!
Did he show mercy when my husband was suffering? Oh.
This is John's will.
Sorry, Huffy boy.
He had no choice!
He always had a choice! The reason I'm doing this is because I couldn't forgive myself for what you might do to someone else. It's sad I remember all this.
No, Brad!
You're my father, you motherfucker! Oh, that's a massive needle bend.
If he had just gone back.
Or if he just ducked.
He's breaking his hand to slip it out.
Yep. Oh. And look at the bone on his hand.
Yeah, that's gotta hurt.
Did you see the bone popping out?
Yeah, that's gotta hurt.
Oh, oh, yum! Oh, and the bone, and then he slips it out of the fucking shackle. Oh, that would hurt so much. That makes me cringe every fucking time. Because imagine if you got the bone caught on the strap.
Ugh. Rip! And now he's gonna slip out. Woo! That's gotta hurt.
Nah, shit. And that was Saw 6.
Now I'm gonna wait to see Saw 3D.
What the fuck was that? Alright. Well, that was Saw 6. What did you think?
I liked it.
You liked it?
I guess.
Is... Where do you rank it so far upon the Saw movies? As mid-tier, high-tier, or low-tier?
Low.
You just said you fucking liked it.
I lied. Nah, it's high.
A high tier? One of the better ones? Because I know you liked 5 and 4 and 1, but you didn't like 2.
I didn't like 4.
I thought you did. I posted your actual grade on Letterboxd, okay? Let me look this up. You gave it a 4 out of 5, dipshit.
Oh.
Then you also gave Saw 5 a 4. But what were the things that you liked in Saw 6?
The traps.
The traps? Is that because they're less gory, more psychological?
Yeah.
It's only really gory with that opening trap and that final trap. Uh-huh. Do you think that works better in regards to the Saw trap formula, having more psychological throughout, but gory big traps at the beginning and end?
Yeah. I will admit, one thing I wish Saw would get rid of is the big, long maze traps. No one needs them!
In regards to Saw 6, what grade would you give it out of 5?
4.5.
A 4.5 out of 5. So that's the same grade you gave the first Saw movie. Are you confident with that?
Yes.
You liked it that much?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, there we go. Aaron gave Saw 6 a 4.5 out of 5, which makes me very happy. As Saw, you know, 6, as you guys know, is one of my favorite Saw films. But guys, that is our reaction to Saw 6. Her first time watching. Really glad she enjoyed it. Aaron, have you got anything to say before we wrap this up?
Let me think.
Anyway, guys, thank you so much for joining. She talked too fucking long. Thank you so much.
I will be very disappointed in Saw 3D if it's another maze. And I'm expecting it to be bad.
Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching this video. If you did enjoy it, please be sure to drop a like down below. It really does help out the channel. Do be sure to also click the subscribe button and the bell to get notified when new videos are up every single week. Look out for my reactions coming very, very soon for Hostiles Part 2 and 3, as well as Cube 3, as well as, you know, Fear Street Part 2 and Part 3, as well as Saw 3D coming very, very soon, as well as Resident Evil Apocalypse. Thank you all so much for joining, and I'll see you all in the next video. Take care.